Hey guys, I am super excited to show you how you can create an awesome looking silver metallic cinematic title animation inside of After Effects without using any third-party plugins or anything else. You can use this animation to create New Year and Christmas presentation for this year. This is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's get started. Alright, so here we are in the After Effects, and if you are new on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is going to be our main composition, so let's call it main. And set the size of this composition maybe 1920 in width, 1080 in height, and you have to select a frame rate. So in this case, I am using this 30 frame per second, but of course you can select any frame rate that you like. You can select 60 frame per second for smooth animation, or you can just keep it 24 frame per second for cinematic. We have to set the duration of this composition maybe 10 seconds long, which is good enough, and hit OK. Now we have to type a text right over here. So select this text tool and go to this character option. If you don't have this character, then go to window and check this option character, and let's select any font style. So in this case, I am using this lemon milk font style. You can select any font style that you like. Now let's set the style maybe medium, and we have to set the size of this font maybe 275 pixel, line spacing 275 pixel. Alright, and once you have done this, click over here and type anything that you like. Just like that, hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and now let's align this text in the center. So just go to this align, click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically, and again, if you don't have this align option, then go to window and check this option align. Alright, and now select this text, right click on that, click on pre-compose, let's call it text. So this is the text composition. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, and hit OK. And now let's animate the text. So select this text composition, hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on a scale property at the very beginning of this animation, and go to the end of this animation, and let's set the size maybe 80%, and we will get zoom out animation as you can see. Alright, and after that we have to create text reveal effect. So select this move tool and let's take a new solid layer. Let's call it reveal. Hit OK, and now turn off the visibility of this layer by clicking on this I button, and we have to create circular mask around this text. So select this ellipse tool, hold left mouse button, hold Alt, Control and Shift, and create multiple circular shape just around the text. Let's minimize the reveal text layer and turn on the visibility of this reveal layer. Select this move tool, hit M on the keyboard to open this mask property, select all the masks just like this by holding Shift, hit M to close, and hit M 2 times to open mask property just like this, and go to on 3 seconds right over here, and let's increase the mask expansion value something like this and cover all the black part just like this. So we have to set this value maybe 300 pixels, and now let's animate this. So turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on mask expansion, go to on 8 seconds and add one more keyframe and lock the value as it is. Go to the end of this animation and we have to set this mask expansion value -200. Go to very first frame of this animation, let's set this value -200 again, and we will get something like this as you can see. Alright, now you can close this layer and select this reveal. Set the CTI right over here, go to Effect and Preset and search for Roughen Edges. So this is the Roughen Edges effect. Let's apply this Roughen Edges on this revealed layer and let's do some settings. So just go to this effect control and let's increase the borders, maybe 100, edge sharpness 10. Let's increase the stretch width and height, maybe 50. Now select the text layer, go to track matte. If you don't have this track matte, then click on this toggle switches and change this track matte to alpha matte. All right, and finally we will get something like this. And now select both the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be text composition. Check this option, move all attributes, and hit OK. After that, select this text composition, right click on that, go to layer style, and here we have to click on this bevel and emboss and open this bevel and emboss effect, and let's increase the size and set it to 20. Let's increase this highlight opacity and set it to 100. Now you can close this effect, you can close this layer, and then select this text composition, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be the bevel, so let's call it bevel. And again check this option, move all attributes, and hit OK. And now you can turn off the visibility of this bevel layer. All right, and now let's create a reflection map. So just go to the composition and take a new composition, and this is going to be the map, so let's call it map. Hit OK. And we have to take a new solid layer, so just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer, and hit OK. Just go to effect and preset and search for fill effect. Just drag this fill effect on the solid layer. Let's select the gray color, maybe light gray color, hit OK. After that, select this white solid, hit Ctrl D to create a duplicate, make this a little bit darker, just like this, hit OK. And after that, we have to create a mask. So select the top layer, select this rectangle tool, and let's create a rectangular shape, just like this. All right, and after that, click on this blank area and click on this fill, set it to solid color. Select this color pure white, hit OK. Click on this stroke and set it to none. And now let's create shape something like this. And now let's close this shape layer. Select this shape layer, go to effect and preset and search for drop shadow. Let's apply this drop shadow on this shape layer. And let's increase the distance and set it to maybe 50. Let's increase the softness and set the softness maybe 120. And let's increase the opacity and set it to 90% maybe. All right, so this is the map. Now just go to main composition and let's import this map into this main composition. Hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it down and set it to 75%. Go to effect and preset and search for motion tile. Let's apply this motion tile on this map. Let's increase the output width and set it to 300. And after that, just go to the end of this animation and let's animate the tile center. So this is the tile center X value and this Y value. So I'm going to animate the X value. All right. So turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on tile center. Let's set the value maybe 2500. And go to very first frame of this animation and let's set it to 1500. And finally, we will get something like this. And now select this map, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be reflection map, so let's call it reflection. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And after that, let's go to the project window and let's import this text composition into this main composition. After that, select this reflection, go to track matte. If you don't have this track matte, then click on this toggle switch edge. Change this track matte to alpha matte. All right, and we will get something like this. And after that, select this reflection composition, go to effect and preset and search for CC glass. Let's apply the CC glass on this reflection, and we have to do some basic settings. So open this surface, select this layer, maybe bevel, go to property and set it to luminance. Let's down the softness value and set it to 9, and let's increase the height. So I'm gonna set it to 100, and let's increase the displacement to 150. All right, and we will get something like this. And now we have to add one more effect. So just go to effect and preset and search for CC blobilize. So this is the CC blobilize. Let's apply this on reflection layer. And again, open this blobilize, select the layer bevel, change this property to alpha. And here let's down the softness value and set it to 6. And finally, we will get glossy silver metallic text, which is looking very awesome as you can see. And now click on fit button. Select all layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and let's call it animation. And again, check this option, move all attributes into the new composition and hit OK. All right, and now we have to create a background. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer, hit OK. Let's drag this solid layer below this animation, right click on that, click on rename, and let's call it BZ for background. And after that, we have to apply gradient ramp. So let's search for ramp. And this is the gradient ramp effect. Let's apply this gradient ramp on this background. Click on this option, swap color, and let's change this ramp shape to radial ramp. And we have to create a gray background just like this. Hit OK. And after that, select this animation and search for drop shadow. Let's apply this drop shadow effect on this animation, and let's increase the distance and set it to 20. Let's increase the softness maybe 50, and let's increase the opacity maybe 70%. And now we have the drop shadow effect, as you can see. All right, and now let's add some grains on it to avoid the color bending. So select the background, go to effect and preset and search for grains. So this is the add grain effect. Let's apply this add grain on this background, and we have to set the preview to final output. And let's select the preset, maybe Kodak SFX, and let's turn off the animation. So open this animation, and we have to set the animation speed 0. Click on fit button, and after that we have to add some particles on it. So let's take a new solid layer, call it particles. Just go to effect and preset and search for CC particles. So this is the CC particle system 2. Let's apply this. Let's set the birth rate value 2. Open this producer. And here we have to set the radius Y maybe 40, X radius 80. Open this physics, and here let's down the velocity and set it to 0.1, gravity 0, resistance maybe 25. You can close this physics, open the particle, and here we have to select this motion polygon. You can set the birth size 0.01, death size 0.5 maybe. You can set the max opacity 100, and I'm gonna set the color maybe pure white for the birth color, pure black for the death color. And now let's animate the particle. So let's close this particle first, open this producer, and just go on to second and click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on birth rate, and just go on 1 second and set it to 0. And again, just go on 8 second right over here. Hit U on the keyboard to open this active keyframe. Click on this diamond button to add a keyframe on 8 second. Go on 9 second right over here, and let's set the birth rate 0. All right, and we will get something like this. And after that, let's close this layer. And now we have to animate this X radius and Y radius. So what we have to do, just go on 2 second right over here. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on X radius. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on radius Y. Let's set the radius Y value 0. Go on 1 second right over here, and I'm gonna set this radius X value 0. Go on 3 second, and again set the radius Y value 40. And it's almost done. So just go to very first frame of this animation, click on fit, go to full screen, and let's have a look. All right, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.